I got an email that said, "Hi, I am from the Spatial Orientation Laboratory at Brandeis University. Would you like to go in our space chair?" Yes. Yes, I would.
The lab does like a whole variety of different things. Space research, spatial orientation. How does a person know where they are in space? We also look at artificial gravity. We look at human postural balancing, sensory motor adaptation and processing. We do some sorts of modeling as well. And we've had a history of looking at motion sickness. There's a lot that we don't know about. When does spatial disorientation happen and how can we resolve it?
That went wrong, okay.
The first question of this project is, can we recreate essentially what an astronaut would experience, that sort of weak sense of gravitational cues and the spatial disorientation on Earth? And the way we do it is we put people into this beast, this machine, we blindfold them so they can't use their visual system, noise-canceling headphones so they can't use their auditory system. They're just falling to the left and to the right. And because they're tilting relative to gravity, you can use information about how you are relative to gravitational vertical to figure out where you are. And you're getting this information a little bit through your skin as you push against that seat, but a lot through your vestibular system.
And it's so easy to just overcorrect and over, yeah, there we go.
If we want to know how the brain works in space flight, we need to approximate the whole variety of conditions and forces without limiting it to just one axis. So we started designing a multi-axis rotation and tilt system, which we call MARS. It became operational about 12 years ago. And about 10 years ago, we flew it on the Vomit Comet. It was actually the biggest piece of equipment and the heaviest that they flew.
Okay.
What parabolic flight gives us is the ability to test in close proximity several gravity inertial force environments. I flew a lot in zero G. I probably have more zero G time clocked than some astronauts.
So this chair is balanced on a metaphorical knife edge, and my job is to keep it upright, but I can't shift my body weight, and I've got no cues for my eyes or my ears. Instead, all I have is this joystick. And you know what? I don't think I'm doing too badly at this.
Your inner sense of balance is inside your inner ear, and your otolith organs are these little hairs that tell you how much you tilt. In the upright, those hairs tilt the more you deflect, and you have a good sense of where you are. When you're on your back, the only thing that you really have through your canals and even through your skin is velocity. So I take the people and I tilt them until they're on their back. And because they're not tilting relative to gravity anymore, you can't really use gravitational cues to figure out where you are, and people become wicked spatial disoriented.
Whoa, okay.
You know, I put pilots inside there, they don't know where they are. 90% of people have no idea. One of the core things I was very interested in was how do people learn over time? People in the upright who have a good sense of where they are, I was curious, well, what does learning look like even in that condition? Because no one had even looked at that. And so we took data and we 3D printed each of the trials. So this is trial one, and this is going all the way up to trial 20. And if you have huge circles, that means you're really bad. And as time goes by, people learn. In the beginning, people come in and they're stressed out, you know, and what they do is they grasp that joystick and they are just doing these crazy maneuvers, thinking that they need to respond to every small thing. Pretty rapidly, people are able to learn to do this task. This is our space flight analog task. This is when you're on your back. You don't have gravitational cues that tell you about your angular position. It is just a mess. People are in it for 40 minutes and very, very minimal learning. There are some small things that they learn, and that's what I use to create a training program that's actually effective. And these red marks here are destabilizing joystick deflections. This is when you make a deflection of the joystick that actually throws you away from the balance point because you're kind of disoriented.
Did I just steer into the fall?
Based on what I've been looking at, there are really two times that this happens. One, it's just some weird freak thing where they're just like, you know, and who knows why that happens. We need to study more. We want to do imaging and things like that. But the second time it happens is timing. People are doing this joystick deflection and they sort of hold on to the joystick a little too long and that becomes destabilizing.
This is impossible.
I look at learning. I look at how do you create effective training programs. And I also look at, you know, can we do technological countermeasures that can help people in that condition?
Thank you to all the team at the Spatial Orientation Laboratory at Brandeis University. Pull down the description for more about them and their work. That is genuinely impossible. I'm talking really loud. Cool.